Alright y'all, so I did pick up a bunch of new things from the drugstore, and I did not haul them, so I'm just going to go ahead and haul them in here, I guess you could say. But yeah, so I guess we'll just get right into it. I just went ahead and picked some stuff up. Most of the stuff is from Target or Walmart. And the first thing I'm going to start off with is moisturizing. So I decided to pick up this Pond's little moisturizer. It's actually the travel size. It's super tiny. So I'm just going to go ahead and moisturize my face with this. And this smells really good on the skin. It smells amazing. I'm sorry if the lighting's like super terrible. So I guess I'll just chit chat while I'm getting ready, I guess. I next want to use, I actually don't have a primer, so I'm just going to go ahead and go in with this one because this is one of my favorite primers. And it's like more of a silicone texture to the face, so if you don't like silicone-y primers, then you probably won't like this. But this is the Hard Candy Sheer MB Primer. I'm just going to put this on one side of my face because the foundation that I want to use, I want to see the lasting power that it has. So I'm just going to put this on the primer on this side of the face. Alright, so the foundation I want to use today is the CoverGirl Stay Luminous Foundation. Just looks like that. This just came out like a week ago. This is kind of similar to the Stay Fabulous, but this is the luminous kind, and that other one is more of like a matte finish. But it says it gives skin even coverage and natural glow that lasts all day. I also saw the primer next to it, but they were all out of the primer. So I just decided to pick up the foundation. But yeah, so pick this up, and this is in the color Soft Honey. So hopefully this is a good shade for me. I don't know, it looks like it will be. It might be a little bit too light, but we'll see. Let's go in with this baby. So I'm happy that it has a pump. I really like that. So it has a lock on it, so that's good. I like that. I'm just gonna pump this on my skin. I'm just gonna pump this on my hand. See how this goes. I'm gonna use my Real Techniques sponge on one side of my face and then a brush on the other side to see how it looks. So I'm just gonna zoom in. So here's the foundation, and we're just gonna dot this all over the face. It smells like paint. Yeah, it smells like paint you would paint your room with. It looks like it'll be a good match for me. Even if it's a little too light, I can just darken it up with some bronzer and it'll all be okay. I'm just going to use my Real Techniques sponge with on this side of the face, and then on this side of the face I'm going to use my Real Techniques brush that I use to buff in some foundation. So yeah, start out with this. It's blending really well. It's blending very well. I'm really, really, really impressed on the blending ability that this foundation has. It's a really good consistency. So, wow, it looks really good. That looks awesome. You can see the dewiness that it has. Okay, so that looks amazing. I'm liking it so far. So now I'm going to use my Real Techniques buffing brush and on this side of the face. So let's see how it buffs onto the skin. Hopefully it's not streaky. A little bit streaky. So I might have to go in with the sponge. Alright, so you can see the difference with the sponge and with the brush. So I'm loving the sponge side better than the buffing brush side. So I'm just going to go ahead and use my sponge and blend it all out to make it look better, because I'm not liking it with the brush. So did anyone see Caitlyn Jenner? I just saw the pictures like an hour ago and I was in complete shock. I was like, who is this? What a transformation. Like, how beautiful does she look? Like, you go girl, do you boo boo, do you. Alright, so I'm gonna just add a little bit on this side just to see if it cakes up or not. Alright, so far it is not cakey. I think you can build up the coverage with this foundation and you won't cake it up. So that's really good about a foundation. All right, so I'm loving this. So far, I'm loving it. Let's see the lasting power and see if it creases during the day. So that is the foundation. For concealer, I didn't pick up a new concealer because there weren't really new concealers out. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use my Master Conceal to conceal my under eyes. So I'm starting a little bit late today because I actually went grocery shopping earlier, and so I didn't want to wear makeup to go grocery shopping. But tonight my nephew is graduating from fifth grade and we're gonna go to his graduation, and I'm so excited to see him graduate because he's super excited. And so I'm just gonna do my makeup for that occasion, I guess. It's at his school and it's tonight, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do my face. And I thought it would be a good idea to film this first impressions for you, because I've been wanting to use that foundation for a while, and it's just been sitting there because I wanted to film a first impressions. So now I have my foundation and concealer. Now I want to set my face with the NYC BB Radiance powder, and I'm loving this powder. It is so smooth and creamy. I'm obsessed with this powder. So I'm just gonna use this because I don't really have another new powder to use. So I'm just gonna use this one, and I'm just gonna set my whole face with this. And this is in the color Naturally Beige. So for eyebrows, I picked up the NYX eyebrow gel. So this is like the little tube of the NYX eyebrow gel, and I got the color brunette. It just looks like this. It's a little squirting tube, and it has 0.34 fluid ounces of product in here, so that's pretty good. I'm just gonna get a regular angled brush. So this is actually one of my favorite angled brushes. I've had them for years, like years, since I was like in middle school, I think. And it's my absolute favorite angled brush. I don't know what brand it is, and I think it might be BH Cosmetics. I have no idea, but my mom actually bought me like a huge brush set when I was in middle school, and that was one of the brushes in the brush set, and I absolutely love it. So I guess I'm just gonna squirt a little bit on the back of my hand. I don't know how to use this. So it just looks like that. I'm gonna grab a little bit with my brush. Super thick. All right, let's hope I don't have Chola eyebrows by the end of this video. I heard really good things from this eyebrow gel. I heard it's like bulletproof. And I hope that is true, because I always have a problem with my eyebrow products that I put on my eyebrows smearing, and it don't look cute at all. And I've been struggling with my eyebrows because they always smear. But so far this is working very well. It's very easy to work with and very creamy. And a little bit goes a long way with this. So it looks pretty good, I think. So there's one eyebrow done. So it's looking pretty good. So far I'm liking it and how it goes on. My eyebrows are sisters, not twins, so they're not gonna look exactly the same. I've always had a problem with that, with my eyebrows looking completely different than the other. But it took me a while to accept that they're not always gonna look the same. But you can make them look similar. Okay, so that's as similar as they're going to get, and so far I am loving this. This works so well. So if you have a hard time with eyebrow products, this is like super easy to work with. And it's already dry. So hopefully this stuff is bulletproof, because baby girl needs some bulletproof stuff for her eyebrows, because my eyebrows have issues. Like, they do not hold on to product very well. So I picked up another one of these Wet n Wild contouring palettes. I actually picked up one of these already, and it was in Dulce de Leche, and it was a little bit too light for me, so I decided to pick up this one in Caramel Toffee. And let's see how this works out for my skin, because the other one was way too light and it would not show up on my skin. So let's see how these work. Oh, they look a little bit too light still. I don't know. It's very cool toned. So I guess we'll try this out, and if I don't like it, I'm just gonna have to go in with another contouring powder. So let's just go in with this. But it is showing up on my skin. It's a very cool tone, and I'm more of a warm tone girl. I like my stuff to be very warm. I love my bronzers to be very warm. And this is very cool, so it's looking good so far. Alright, I'm really liking it, actually. It's better than the Dulce de Leche, because the other one did not show up at all on my skin, and I did not like that. Homegirl needs a harsh contour. I always feel like I look like Chili from TLC, because she had a bunch of baby hairs back in the 90s, and that's how I feel. I feel like Chili from TLC. If you don't know who TLC is, oh my god. I'm just gonna add a little bit on my nose to contour the nose. I guess for my under eyes, I'll use this powder. And to carve out my contour, I'll use that powder also. So I'm just going to use my e.l.f. small tapered brush to set my under eyes. So I'm just going to get a little bit of product from this. Just looks like that, and top off the excess. I'm just going to set my under eyes. And then I'm going to carve out my contour down here. I've been loving carving out my contour, because it gives it more of a dramatic look. And that's the look I want to go for today. Go dramatic or go home, right? So that's the contour that I'm going to go for today. So now I'm going to go in with... Do you like how I change my accents? Okay, so now I'm going to go in with the e.l.f. blush palette. I haven't used this yet, and this is what it looks like. This is in the light palette, so I think I want to use that one. So that's the color I'm going to go in with. They don't have color names on it, so just that one. I'm going to go in with that one. It has little specks of glitter, and I'm going to go in with my Equal Tools brush and chop off the excess and Okay, so that's the blush. It's very pretty. Alright, so now I want to go in with the, I actually bought two highlighters, and I don't know which one to wear. I bought the Revlon Rose Glow Highlighting Palette, and this is how it looks like. It's super pretty. I've been eyeing this for a while, and I just never picked it up. And that's what it looks like, and I finally did. And also, I picked up the Physicians Formula Shimmer Strips in Warm Nude. What this one looks like. Super pretty. And what I like about these is that you can also wear them as eyeshadows. So this is awesome. So I think I might want to go in with this one. This is what this one looks like. Super pretty. And what I like about these is that you can also wear them as eyeshadows. So this is awesome. So I think I might want to go in with this one. Which one am I feeling today? The Revlon one looks like. Can't really see it. You can see it right there. Sounds super pretty. And I'll just swatch this one also. Alright. That one is the Physicians Formula one. So I think I'm going to go in with this one. So I'm just going to grab the two rows of the lightest colors right here, and I'm just gonna dip my brush into those and highlight. Okay, that is so pretty. I really like a dramatic highlight. Do you see that? I'm loving this. I'm just gonna put a little bit on my nose and on my forehead. So I think I'm done with the face. What do you think so far? I think everything looks really good. Okay, so now I'm going to go in with the L'Oreal La Palette Nude 2. I hauled the Nude 1 in my most recent haul that I did, and I said I didn't like it that much, and I really don't like it that much. Like, it's not my favorite palette ever. But yeah, I decided to pick this one up because I heard that this one was a lot better than the first one. So we'll see. We'll put that to the test. It has more of purples and cool tones in this palette, and I really don't use that many purples on my eye looks, but this is making me want to use more purples because they're so pretty. Look at how pretty that is. So this actually costs like $15 at Walmart and Target. So yeah, let's just go in with that. So I'm going to go ahead and prime up my eyelids with the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. I love using this. Alright, so I'm going to bring this up to my brow bone because I want to highlight my brow bone. Alright, so does anyone watch Devious Maids? I feel like I'm the only one, well, me and my sister, I feel like we're the only ones that watch it. Nobody goes crazy over Devious Maids. But I am obsessed. I love it. Today is June 1st and the new season comes out tonight, and I'm so excited. So after I come home from my nephew's graduation, I'm gonna sit down, eat me a piece of cake, and watch me some Devious Maids because I'm so excited for this season. I think it's gonna look good. So if anyone else watches Devious Maids, let me know, because I feel like me and my sister are the only ones that watch it because we're crazy for it. Alright, so I'm just going to go in with this brush. This is just a regular eyeshadow brush from Target. It was like $2, I think. And I think I want to go in, so I'm going to go in with this color right here, the lightest color in the palette. And I'm just going to use that as my brow bone highlight. So let's just use that. Okay, so far the brow bone highlight looks really good. Alright, so I want to go in with this color right here as my transition shade. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use this e.l.f. blending eye brush. So you can see all the product on my brush, and I'm just gonna tap it off and put this in my crease as a transition shade. I'm just gonna go ahead and go in with this other e.l.f. brush. This is actually a concealer brush, but I use it to blend out my eyeshadows. It's one of my favorite brushes ever. I actually started a blog, y'all. So I'm so happy. I haven't mentioned anything about my blog that I started. How could I forget about mentioning that on my YouTube, right? But yes, I started a blog, and I'm so happy how it came out. I actually started it on Mother's Day. I actually created it a long time ago, like a year ago, I think, but I never really worked on it or anything, and I finally just sat down and worked on my blog, and I love it, how it looks and everything. So go check it out. I put reviews up of new products that I try out and that I love on my blog, so go check it out. It's actually Miss Valerie Makeup. I'll put the URL somewhere around here. It's MISS Valerie Makeup. So yeah, I was so happy that to start that, and it looks super cute, and I'm happy with it. So check it out. I really hope y'all like it, and I hope my reviews are helpful in any kind of way. All right, so I'm just gonna go ahead and go in with this color right here. I'm just gonna deepen my crease with this a little bit. So I really, really, really wanna go see that new movie that just came out. It's called San Andreas. The Rock's in that movie, and I really, really wanna go see it. My sister and my brother-in-law actually already went to go watch it. And they asked me to go with them, but it was raining and I didn't want to go. I don't know if any of y'all heard, but it's raining really bad here in Texas. And I hope it stops, but yeah, it's been raining really bad. And it was raining the day that they went and I was just freaking out. I was like, no, I do not want to go anywhere. I just want to stay home. So I regret not going with them because they told me it turned out to be a really good movie, and a lot of people have been saying that it's like a must-see, so I really, really want to go see that movie. With this purple shade, this is in the color number 9 right here, and I'm just going to just stick that in my crease also. I don't know what brush to use. I'm still using this e.l.f. brush, so I'm just going to use this just to give it more color. So it doesn't have any fallout. I don't know if it's because I'm tapping out the excess, but usually when I use eyeshadows, I get eyeshadows like all under here, under my eyes, and I have to go in with concealer again. But I don't think I'm going to have to this time because I don't see any eyeshadow under my eyes, so that's a good thing. Alright, so the eyeshadows look great. So now I'm going to go in with, I think I want to go in with this color right here for my entire eyelid. Alright, so then I'm going to go ahead and go in with this color again. And I'm going to go in with that color and put it in my inner tear duct. Just to highlight that part of my eye. Alright, so there is Zeke. I look, now I want to go in with some eyeliner. I'm just going to go ahead and go in with my NYC liquid eyeliner. I've used this already. For special occasion, if I ever done your makeup, okay, you know that I get like super like nervous when I do eyeliner. So that's as good as it's gonna get. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go in with my Jordana and L'Oreal Telescopic Shopping Extensions Mascara, and I'm just going to go in with that. So that's just usually the mascaras I always use, so I'm just going to speed up through this. Alright, so now I want to, I guess, deepen up my eyeshadow, so I'm just going to go back to the L'Oreal La Palette Nude Tool, and I'm just going to pick up this. This is the darkest shade in the palette. And I'm actually going to go in with a little brush that it comes with. It comes with this little brush, and it has this brush applicator and then a sponge applicator. But I'm going to use the little brush part of the applicator. So it looks good. So I feel like I'm liking this palette a lot better than the first one.
The first one has some good quality, don't get me wrong, but I don't know, I just feel like it's just
so I started thinking about vlogging. I don't know if I want to start vlogging. My life isn't like super interesting, so I don't know. My cousins were actually like, you should start a vlog channel. I was like, I've always wanted to start a vlog channel, but I don't do anything. Like, I never do anything except for going to Target. And most people like to see that, right? So I decided to pick up these new lashes from Salon Perfect. So you can get these at Walmart. And these are the 614 lashes, and they're just so pretty. And I've actually already used these because I just couldn't help myself because they were just so, so pretty. And I do like them a lot. So I'm just going to go ahead and apply these so you can see how they look. They're only like $2. Okay, so those are the lashes. And I am obsessed. I love these lashes. Alright, so now I'm going to go in with this color again for my lower lash line. And I'm just going to use that color, pop of purple. I'm going to go ahead and use this one right here. Also, I feel like I wanted to give a little bit of a shimmer down there, so I'm going to go ahead and use this one also right here. Pretty. And put a little bit of that light shade again and go over that. So, got that. And I'm gonna put a little bit of mascara down there too. On my lower lash line. Okay. And I think I might want to put some black eyeliner. Alright, so I'm just going to use a regular black eyeliner. So I'm just going to put this on my waterline. Now on to the lips. So for lips, I picked up some essence lipsticks. I got the colors Coral Calling, Oh So Matte, and Nude Love. And this is Nude Love. So I don't know which one I'm feeling today. This one's a little bit too nude for my mood today. Didn't mean to rhyme. I think I want to use Oh So Matte. And then Coral Calling is just a very coral color, which I really don't want to go for coral today. So I might not use this one. Alright, so I'm just going to go in with this Essence Lip Liner in Soft Berry. And I just picked this up yesterday at Ulta. And it just looks like that. It's a dark lip liner. It looks brown. Looks more of a brown than a berry shade, but it's really pretty. So that's it right there. I'm just going to overline my lips with this. So let's just do that. I'm all for the mauve colors and the darker lip liners. And this lip liner is so creamy. And just so pigmented. Look at that. Looks so pretty. Alright, so I'm loving this lip liner. Alright, and the lipstick I want to go in with. I think I want to go in with Oh So Matte by Essence. I've heard a lot of good things about this lipstick. And this is like a really nude lipstick. And I'm going to go in with this one. Very creamy. I feel like I always have the same lip colors, but this is definitely right up my alley. I kind of gave it a little bit of an ombre effect. And I also have this NYX Intense Butter Gloss, and I've been wanting to try this out. I picked this up at Target also, so excited to try this out. And this is so pretty. Like, the color is gorgeous. Look at that. Just looks so pretty. So I'm gonna go with Tres Leches on my lips. And it smells amazing. Alright, so I love the lip combo that I decided to go for. I'm gonna wipe my hand. Alright, so the NYX eyebrow gel that I put on my hand is not coming off. Like, it's like not moving. It's really hard to take off, so that's a good thing. So hopefully my eyebrows don't move, because I have a problem with that. So everything looks so good so far. So I put the primer on this side of my face, and on this side of my face I just used the regular foundation itself without the primer, just to see the lasting power that it's gonna have. But I actually picked up this new thing from Hard Candy. This is actually the Fast and Fabulous Hard Candy Makeup Setting Spray. This says that it's a weightless spray that locks in makeup for all day wear. So I'm super excited to put this to the test. I'm actually going to go ahead and put this on the side of my face where I have the primer. I heard really good things about it. So I'm just going to put this on this side of my face where I put the primer. So just cover up this side. So the spray smells really good. It actually smells like cucumbers, so that's a good thing. So far loving the look that I went for today. I'm going to be checking in with you throughout the day, probably in a few hours. But yeah, I just want you to see the lasting power and how my makeup stays on throughout the day. So right now it is 3:36. In the afternoon. I told you I started late. But yeah, I'll check in with you later to see how my makeup stays on through the day. And I will come back and check in with you in a few hours. Alright, so I'm back. I decided to curl my hair earlier for my nephew's graduation. So that's why my hair is curled. But it is already 9:13 at night. So far my makeup's looking pretty good, I think. So I'm absolutely loving the foundation. And the lipstick, I did eat. We actually went to Texas Roadhouse and I ate a huge country fried chicken. And the waitress at Texas Roadhouse actually told me, she was like, oh my goodness, your eyebrows are on point. And I was like, oh, thank you. She was like, people don't really appreciate eyebrows as much as I do. And I was like, oh no, girl. I appreciate eyebrows too, so we're on the same boat. But yeah, she was saying how good my eyebrows look. But little did she know that I was trying out a new product, right? I will be coming back around 11 or 12 when I go to bed. So in about like 2 hours, so I'll check in again one more time. Alright, hey y'all, I'm back and I'm checking in for the very last time. It is 11:55, so it's almost midnight. And I feel like my makeup held on pretty well. I'm actually very, very impressed. The only thing that I do have to say is that, like I said earlier, my the foundation around my nose is completely gone. And my concealer is creasing, and it is because of the powder that I used. So I used this powder to set my concealer. And I would not recommend it to set your concealer because it creases a lot. Usually when I use my other powder that I normally use, it does not crease at all. And this time it's like really, really, really like noticeably creased, and it does not look good. But other than that, I like the contour. The contour looks really, really good. It's still on my face, which I'm really impressed by. I'm really, really impressed with the NYX eye gel. I'm really impressed with that. It looks really good, so I'm really, really liking that. The primer and the setting spray, you can get away without using these, so yeah. But if you're like me and you need to set your makeup with something, this is a good option. It's only $6 at Walmart, so pretty good option, and it smells pretty good too. The lip products are completely gone. I have no product on my lips, and that's because I ate, I drank, and I ate again. So that's why I did not retouch my lips at all. So yeah, they held on pretty good. So they held on for a good 4 to 5 hours, I would say. Now that it's completely gone, I did not rub it off, so this is just how it looks like when you eat and drink and stuff, so it just comes off. And I really like this palette too. This palette, I like it better than the first one, definitely. It's way more pigmented, and I really do like that. So, alright, so I'm ready to go to bed and take this makeup off. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And follow me on my social media accounts, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.
So it looks amazing. I really don't have a big oh my god, I can't talk. I really don't have a big vocabulary, don't I? I always say amazing, awesome, gorgeous in every single video because those are the only words I know. Just gonna look like a lot. Oh, seriously, I was just dipping into this. Really now. Really. Right, now I'm gonna use my Real Techniques sponge, or no. So I'm just gonna go, I have a bat in the cave. Okay, so it's blending very well, very, very well. So. Yeah.